Hey everyone, John here, and happy Wednesday. A quick reminder, I am the founder of Whatifi. I'm a recovering visual effects supervisor and head of studio, and I'm using this downtime that we have in the industry right now to build out scenario planning and what-if technology. So if you've been following along, last week I did a post on the great ramp up there, which got a lot of great attention, which was fantastic on that. And it's really about ideas on what it looks like for studios and facilities to sort of plan their ramp back up. So going from just a few projects to more projects, what if we get this award or that award? What about the timings of these awards? So dogfooding is one of the best ways to test your software. So I've done the same thing with one of our fictional VFX companies. So I'm having the joy right now of helping a few studios plan out and project different scenarios for their ramp ups. And here's a little sort of simple example of some of the techniques that we're using to help them do that. So VFX R Us is our fictional company here. And right now we're getting the chance to bid on House of the Dragon, the next season of Stranger Things, and Orphan Black. Although I just read that Stranger Things is actually pushing out another year, which I could actually build in the model if we wanted to. So with Whatifi, you can connect together these pre-built business logic events to create multiple scenarios like we're living in the multiverse. In this simple model alone, I already have 8 different potential outcomes with different revenue amounts, different terms, different expectations, different locations, all of that. So I'm going to show you an example of House of the Dragon, which is very simple. I'm going to show you an example of Stranger Things. I'm going to open this up. Where Stranger Things, we look at splitting the work between a couple of different offices. And I'm going to show you an example of Orphan Black Season 2. And this one's even more granular, where we're getting into actual bids, actual departments, and sort of seeing what the profile looks for artists' needs over time. Here I have House of the Dragon. So on a very simple level, I'm saying House of the Dragon 201. This is the dollar value. It's going to run for 6 months. I've got a place that I'm going to store that dollar value from, and I've got a start date. And able to do that for every single episode here right now to sort of model out what our bid looks like and our timelines. So something like that, I can very easily go into my history of accounts here, and I can look at income, and I can look at just the House of the Dragon, or I can even look at the individual episodes if I want to, and I can bubble these up. And now I can see the profile. And what I'm going to do before I do that is I'm actually going to lock a few things in here. So this is something with Whatifi. It's very easy to lock in scenarios. I'm doing this for presentation purposes right now. So you notice I've gone from 8 scenarios down to 1. Okay. So in this one scenario right now, I can look at House of the Dragon. And here is the revenue profile month by month by month for all of those episodes. Or I can also look at the individual episodes as well to see the shape and form of the show. Super high level, but gives you a basic understanding of when that show would land and what the revenue might look like. Okay. Taking that one step further for something like Stranger Things, I've done the same thing here. Stranger Things, I've got 10 episodes, I've got dollar values, I've got amortization periods and how long those shows are going to run for. But here I've done something where I've done a work split. So let's pretend that VFX R Us has an office in Los Angeles, has an office in Atlanta, and an office in Montreal. So what I'm able to do is I'm able to take that Stranger Things income right now, I'm going to take 70% of that, and I'm going to apply it to the Montreal location, or the Atlanta location, or the Los Angeles location. So same thing here, let's pop up a couple of accounts. Now I can also add in my income for Stranger Things, so I'm going to add that. But I'm also going to go to a display account here where I created location-based revenue. So I can also track Montreal, Atlanta, and Los Angeles. And with this current work split, and I could very easily try different work splits, with this current work split, here's what Stranger Things looks like. Let's compare that with House of the Dragon. So we see them both, and they're kind of lining up at the same time there. But I can also just look at Montreal, Atlanta, and Los Angeles, and just see the revenue for both of those locations monthly or cumulatively over time. All right. Cool. So that's the next piece, but now let's get even more granular. So maybe we're past this sort of rough stage and now we're trying to figure out the actual nuances of teams. And do we have the people we need? Do we need to ramp up more? What's our hiring strategy look like? So Orphan Black is an example. Same sort of thing where I have all the episodes and all the revenues. But here what I'm actually doing is I'm actually pulling in the bids themselves. And here I think I'm doing something pretty cool. These are simplified again, but if I look at Orphan Black 201 here, I'm able to now, per bid, per department, pull in the days that we bid and the duration of those tasks. So they can be the full range of the show, or they can be Gantt charted here. And I'm saying that I'm going to need 82 days worth of tracking to get this work done, but I can also have a distribution. All right. So we all know that tracking is one of those departments that starts fast and then slows down, especially if there's a lot of CG work. So I can build a profile here for that work depending on what I know about the project. Same thing with lighting, for example, right? I have 193 days here, but here I want a different distribution. I want to sort of start slow, build up a lot, and hopefully that team is winding down. And then lastly, compositing. As we all know, sadly, compositing is always kind of left to last. So here is a profile where really we're backloading that in the kind of current schedule there. And the idea here is not just to take the number of days that we bid and evenly distribute them over a period of time, but to instead try and do a reflection of the reality of production. And we can try different curves here to see what those different production profiles look like. Right? So I can do that for every single episode in here. Here's episode 2, for example. It has a different profile. And maybe here for tracking, if we look at its profile distributed, it's got a longer run and it's looking like this, or maybe it's looking like this, or maybe there's a trailer delivery that we need to think about like this. So what does that give me? Well, I can kind of go in and yes, on a high level, same sort of thing. I can take a look at Orphan Black's revenue here. So there's Orphan Black, and again, the individual episodes. And now I can see Orphan Black, and I can see again in comparison with these other shows to see what it looks like when they all stack up. Or if I'm looking at income overall, I can see all of them combined. Let's do that. All of our data here is nested, so we can get a sense of all of that combined that's here. But I also give you the ability now to look at things on a resources needed basis. So I'm going to go into employees needed here, right? And I'm going to bring up, for example, all of the Orphan Black work, right, for those episodes. So on a high level, now I'm actually seeing the profile of the show. So this is what 201 looks like for artists, and 202, and 203, and 204. So I'm getting the shape of the show for resource planning. And if we want to, we can go deeper still, and I show you there's a couple of ways of doing this. I can also look at it in a view like this, and maybe we're just looking at compositors needed. And I can see all of the compositors that are going to be needed in this traditional sort of workflow here right now. So there's all my needed compositors. Here's all my needed compositors. Or the same sort of thing over here is I can bubble up, you know, the artists needed on a per department basis if required. All right. So cool. We've got all that, but we know the business is in flux right now and there's lots of changes. So what are some of our what ifs? Well, what if for Stranger Things we get 100% of the award of what we bid? What if we get 60%? What if we get 20%? Or what if we don't get any award at all? Because that's going to influence how many artists we have, how many we're going to need, what our budgets and revenue are. So there's a few ways. Here I've gone granular and I've put in specific artists, but we could also do something which is just a nice big round number, quick math, especially when things are changing all the time. So here what I've done is I've created a variable saying that, you know, maybe in this particular space, we can expect to generate $15,000 a month per artist, right? And this is a variable that we can change and play with over time. So what I want to do is I want to take, for all of this work, I want to take a count of the revenue and divide it by that number to very easily generate a quick napkin math version of how big our team needs to be. So I use this event here. It's a very simple version, but I'm taking all of our income and I'm dividing it by all of our average revenue per artist, and I'm spitting that out into an account called Artists Required. So again, our technology is much more like an accounting package where you have all these nested accounts and they can all roll up. So here I'm able to find the display account and my Artists Required, and I'm going to display that. And now I can see in this particular scenario how many artists I'm going to require every month. We can get granular into those departments to see what the profile of the show looks like. And where does that get interesting? That gets interesting when we start looking at different award scenarios. So this here is what's called a modifier. And that modifier allows us to point to some upstream value. And as we're stepping through these calculations every day, think of it like rendering. We step from node to node to node to node, day by day by day by day, and run all these calculations. the modifier can run through pre-processes and says, hey, I don't actually want you to run the calculations you have here. First, I want you to multiply them by 60% or 20% or zero in each of these different versions of the multiverse to be able to spit out a calculation. All right. So here I'm saying, let me just turn this on here, otherwise a little error pops up. Here I'm saying, I want to build a model where I look upstream, and I look specifically at Stranger Things, and I'm looking at all of the episodes, and I can cherry pick these if I want to, and I'm looking at the income value, and I want to say I want to multiply that by 0.6. So we're only getting 60% of that revenue there. So you may have noticed that behind the scenes, we've now calculated four different models here right now. And if I turn this on right now, we can see that our required artists are changing in each of these scenarios now that I'm augmenting different percentage awards for Stranger Things. Quick and ham-fisted, but it does the job of giving you a quick sense of what a profile looks like. Additional to that, we might be talking about shows delaying. So I'm also able to hear and say, well, what if House of the Dragon, that's all great, but we're hearing rumors of a schedule push or something like that. I can also modify dates too. So here in this example, I am, turn that off, turn this off. In this example here, I now have a delay where I'm saying I want to reach upstream to that income event that is all the House of Dragon. I want to take up all of those records that are in there, and I want to check that start date, and I want to offset it by 6 months. Okay? So now, if I kind of go back to my profiles here, there are some scenarios like this one, and let me just do this, like this profile here, where I'm now pushing that work out in time, right? So I can now see that my income, and there's a lot of data here, so I appreciate it may not be super easy to see, but I now have two versions of things. In some of my scenarios, my income is delayed and pushed out, and I actually have no income in this month. In other scenarios, that income is all stacked up at the beginning. So it's a quick way of building out these scenarios, building in some probability calculations there. Maybe at the end of the day, we get notified that we've received 60% of Stranger Things. I can lock this piece of information in, and now we have a smaller subset of scenarios to look at as we're making some of our decisions there. Relatively soon, we're going to have the ability to do some advanced grouping. So you'll be able to go through and group anything you want here and perform actions on it. So I can cherry pick episodes and push those out or change values of things on that one. There's a lot more to it, and this is obviously a super simplified example, but this is an example of some of the work that we're doing right now with a couple of VFX studios. Hopefully, we'll be announcing those relatively soon, that we are helping them build out more advanced projections and forecasts for the next couple of months as the industry ramps back up. That's what I got. Happy Wednesday. If you or your team is at all interested in this technology, reach out, let me know, and I'm happy to work with you directly to see if we can bring some balance to the force in your revenue projections. Thanks, everyone.